as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Oklahoma football, brought to you by Budweiser. Beechwood aged for that clean, crisp taste. This Bud's for you. And by USA Web, America's best tasting sports drink. And now, your hosts for Oklahoma football, head coach Barry Switzer and Steve Davis.
Welcome, everyone, to Oklahoma Football Saturday. The University of Oklahoma Sooners travel to Lincoln, Nebraska to take on the Cornhuskers, the number one ranked Cornhuskers in the United States. And they brought home a 17-7 victory over the Nebraska Cornhuskers. Congratulations, Coach.
Thank you. Did you
think it would be that kind of a dominant football game?
I don't think anyone thought it would be that way, except maybe our players. I think this was a game that our players prepared to play in emotionally, mentally, and physically, probably the best preparation that they themselves have ever had any input into, along with our coach's game plan, both offensively and defensively. I think this victory over Nebraska was the most impressive one that we've had. You know, I mentioned after the ball game that usually before they talk about Sooner Magic, us winning in the fourth quarter, a comeback, a few big plays that allow us to win the football game. But what happened Saturday was total domination of the football game from start of the first quarter to the end of the ball game. Our defense, after they scored their first touchdown, they had 12 possessions they didn't make two first downs in. And that's total domination of a team that is the number one offensive football team in college football. And Nebraska is a great football team, but our football team played even greater Saturday.
The defense dominated, but also Charles Thompson played an outstanding game.
That was a key. I think that I had told Charles earlier in the week that if he played like he had been practicing, that he would stun the nation. And because I had confidence that he would play well, and he has the talent to make big plays. Obviously, when you have the running talents that he has, and the quickness and the speed and the mental composure, and for a young man at this point in his career, I was totally confident that he could play that way, and he did.
Coach, the way to the Orange Bowl is through Lincoln, Nebraska, and we'll have first quarter action in just a moment. The best weather you've ever had, Coach, in Lincoln, Nebraska.
No doubt about it. I knew that's one of the reasons we were going to win the ball game. Everything with the cloud, we've been playing under a cloud the last 2 weeks, and it's been following us around, and I knew that we were going to have a bright, sunshiny day. Option play, the first play of the game, we run a trap option, and we pitch the ball for about a 3-yard game to Patrick Collins, who had the game of his career. And the last game is a Sooner, other than the Orange Bowl Classic. We hand the ball off to Rodney Anderson for about a 3 or 4 yard gain. This is the third down play. And the little Charles Thompson jumps up inside on the first option keep. He has it and picks up about 7, first and 10. I thought they were offsides on this play. We run the draw play for about 5, so it's second and 5 here. That was the first and 10 play. Second and 5, trap option again, pitch the ball, attack the outside knee, Collins, and we get a first and 10 here.
At the 45-yard line, first and 10 for Oklahoma.
First possession, they deferred to the second half, and jump in there, Charlie, keep the ball, protect it, little man. Counter out of a spread formation, we were in a wing formation, one back set with a flanker, a little different look, we're on a wing back reverse. Here's a counter pass, and here's the ability and talent of little Charles getting the first down, and his scrambling ability, and he fumbles the football, and he's hit.
First and 10 now at the Nebraska 34.
Rodney for about 4, second and 6. We dominated the line of scrimmage all day long in this ball game. Option play, it's gonna be a third down situation. Motion, counter. And scramble, and he throws a pass to Stafford to get a face mask, and he throws complete to Stafford. Stafford gets the ball inside the 25-yard line for first down, and they had a penalty because face mask.
Coach, it seems like Charles is so more confident than he was against Missouri.
Here's a power play. Yes, he is, and he is a very confident young man, very unusual for his age. We hand the ball to Rodney, and we fumble it at the 8-yard line. Fumble the football, no points, drive the length of the field with the opening kickoff and turn the ball over. It's what we've been doing for the last couple games, so we start off this game doing the same thing.
But that's a tremendous confidence.
We might get Lydell Carr back, and I hope that happens. Darrell Reed from behind. That's a great defensive pursuit right there. It'll be a 1-2-3 punt for Nebraska. Our defense really created great field position for us because they could not move the football. They'd have to punt. We'd move the football, and it created great field position for us all day long. Richard Dillon. Steve Taylor under, motion out of the eye, sprint draw fake, got a scramble with it, throws in the flat, incomplete. Good coverage. Punt the ball away. Fourth down. This kid has not been punting the ball in 9 games for only a 37-yard average. He averaged 46.2 on 9 punts. Unbelievable. Here's Derek White returning, got great field position, ball midfield. Run a draw play, linebacker read it real quick, guessed with us, and for about a yard gain, second and 9. Counter option with motion. Patrick Collins for about 6.
Brings up 3rd down and 4 now.
We hand the ball to Rodney here, and comes up short at about a foot, and we're going to punt the football away. Went against OSU there, but we're not going to go against Nebraska there. We're going to punt the football away, and I tell you what, I was amazed the guy did not signal fair catch. He's got people's bodies flying past him here, and he went ahead and returned the ball. They hand the ball off. They go score. This is the second possession they've had the football, and they go score this, but they have some big individual plays out of Taylor. Here's a big play for him, a screen, hitch screen pass for a first down, their first down of the ball game. Good pursuit. They got the ball at the 30-yard line. They run a counter play to Brinson. I tell you, this guy's got great speed, but there's a guy that's got great speed, too. Throws him for a 3-yard loss. Ricky Dixon, great player. He had a great game.
Brings
great
up second,
game.
13.
Now here's the quarterback draw, and this is the play that hurt us. His quarterback draw. They got him another first down. From second and 13, they throw him for a loss, and he comes back and gets him a first down. And here's end zone Jones. Getting the ball to midfield. Ricky Dixon on that tackle. They're in a spread formation. They run a trap option, counter option. He jumps around, takes about a 2-yard gain.
This brings up 3rd and 2.
3rd and 2. Got to get it here. 3rd and 2, and he gets it, pops the secondary, and we have secondary make the play. I formation, they're going to run the razzle-dazzle throw back free thicker, but we cover him. We got great pass coverage. It didn't fool our secondary. But here's Taylor's ability to scramble and run with the ball after he stands there, can't throw it, and with his quickness and speed, he makes another first down for him.
Gain of 11, now 1st and 10 at the 31.
Counter pass. Great play, Ricky Dixon. Right there. Great play. Boy, he made 2 or 3 plays like that, plus a couple interceptions.
Nebraska
great safety.
Holding.
Here's end zone Jones on a draw play. And this is the poorest we've played the entire ball game. It's one drive. We had a couple of busts on it. And they run a pitch sweep and score here, and we're out of position on this play. And he scores on this play here, 24-yard run, and that's it. We shut it down from here on.
So at the end of the first quarter, Nebraska's leading Oklahoma by the score of 7-0. There's more action to go right here on Oklahoma Football. Nebraska scored their only points, and it gets better from here on.
Here, we would have scored this play right here, had that block right there. We got knocked out. If the fullback had cut the safety, I think Patrick Collins, I looked at the film early this morning. You'll see here the fullback go through. If he throws a block at the safety, great block out of Stafford here, he knocks the corner down. But that block had been a cut block. He's going to outrun everybody else that's on the football field. He would have scored there.
1st and 10 at 41.
Hand off the fullback, Anderson, 2 splits. Anderson again, 1st and 10, ball to midfield. Two tights. Counter option. Choop. Inside him. Good job, Charlie. Charles Thompson. King Charles the sixth. That's what he's got on his towel. Pitch the ball. Patrick Collins again. Good yardage. Ball inside the 30. Well, down to the 32-yard line. Good drive. Got to go score. Put some points on the board. Protect the ball, Charles. Inside the 30 to 27. Pitch the ball sooner. If he pitched the ball sooner, it'd been exciting right there. Stafford speed. So we've got to kick a field goal. And I thought this looked pretty good to me, but looked like it just went right inside the bar there.
It was oh so close.
7-3, we'd like that one. So no points. They're going to shut them down from here on. It's going to be punt, 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 punt. Run the fullback trap, no game. Power play, no game. So it's third down about 7. Watch them run those plays against other people. They just ricochet through other people. That's a great play by Ricky Dixon there. I tell you, we're going to miss him. He is a great football player. Pros tell me he will go our first player pick. They say he'll go before Keith Jackson. Some of them say it'll be hard not to take Keith if he's still on the board, though.
Mm-hmm.
But they really think Ricky's one of the great defensive backs in college football. Face mask.
Coach, the offensive line is just moving bodies.
Surges, coming off. Big bodies getting on people. Keith Jackson, great catch right here. Ball was on top of him, had to make a turning catch. It's a great catch for Keith. 20-yard pass. Counteraction. Good protection. Look at Keith, sees the ball, turns his body, holds on the ball. Big target, and catch the football. Pitch the ball to Collins. 7 yards. Speed on the option. Unbalanced line, short side. And the ball to fullback.
Brings up first and 10 at the 35.
And Roderick Thomas makes a play here. That should have been a penalty. Ball at the 35. Rodney nearly broke that. At the native safety had overrun this. If he had made a clean break of this, he'd probably scored from where he was on the field. Charles Thompson. Where we got the ball? 25-yard line?
25-yard line,
going
first and 10.
Going in to score and fumble the football. Rodney Anderson fumbles. We fumbled 8 times, Steve, in the ballgame. Had 8 fumbles and lost 3 of them. You don't expect to beat Nebraska and do that. And the ball to the fullback. He makes nothing.
They're going to make nothing on this drive. Second 9.
Motion, Brinson, Crosby. They're going to run a reverse. Watch it play to David Vickers. Brinson's got great speed. Pow! Vickers. It'll be 3rd and 5 now. Big play, David. Stung the shoulder. Got a bad shoulder. A little Derek White over there checking him out. Dr. White. Sprint draw, containment, Darrell Reed contains it. Big play, defense, pursuit. Wanted to throw the ball in the flat, and the reason he has to duck up, he can't throw because we've got people covering people. He can't force it in there, he's afraid of an interception. Punt the ball, great. The guy, they had a great kicking game yesterday. Charles Thompson, I tell you what, if that play right there, and I looked at the film 3 or 4 times this morning, went back. If Neil Smith didn't make that play, Charles Thompson might have run 70 yards, just like he did against Texas for a touchdown. I mean, it was clean. The alley was there, and pursuit and overrun, he would have cut against the grain, and he would have been showtime in that play. Charles Thompson runs through him for about 16, 17. Speed and quickness.
The play before was a loss of 1. That was a gain of 18. Brings up 1st and 10 at the 36.
We'll throw the football, nearly intercepted here. Nearly batted back to Carl Cadmus. Wouldn't have been something batted back to him, he'd go score with it. Now a little quarterback draw. Let's go get a first, Charlie. First down.
personal foul on Nebraska. That brings up first and 10.
And we throw an interception. I tell you what, if we had not thrown the football yesterday, I'm not sure that we would have had much more success.
Get to see a replay of the interception.
Just run our offense.
It was an emotional game, Coach, as it always
is. Yeah, we were charged for this one. Our players really were charged. We played hard. Every position, everyone fought, competed, great pass protection, controlled the line of scrimmage both ways.
Did all the pregame talk of Nebraska just add fuel to the fire?
Oh, I think our players responded in a positive manner what came out of Lincoln, but I think it charged our guys up pretty good. There's Darryl Reed from behind. We're going to miss him, too. There are some good senior players out there right now. That's a great play right there. Darren Kilpatrick sacks Taylor for a loss. Killer. Way to go, Killer.
Porter, Oklahoma. The pride of the Porter Peach Festival right there. Great play. The Oklahoma defense making its presence known. It's halftime, and the only 7 points have been scored thus far. Coach Switzer and I will talk about the locker room at halftime as Oklahoma football continues. Coach, even though at halftime it's a 7-0 lead for Nebraska, you've dominated the ball game, 199 yards total yards against their 108. You've had two fumbles, and you've dominated the clock, 19 minutes to their almost 11 minutes.
Well, that was obvious to us and anyone watching the ball game that we were in control of the ball game, except we don't have any points on the board. Our defense has played extremely well, and our offense is moving the football. We've got a tempo. We have a feel right now that we're going to win the football game. I had a lot of confidence going into at the half that we would win the football game the second half because we'd make some things happen, and that's what we did. Our defense made some plays for us, and we still drove the football for over 200 yards the second half. So it was a good 30 minutes in the final one.
What things did you focus on halftime in terms of adjustments that needed to be made?
Really none. The defense made a few adjustments. Gary Gibbs, our coordinator, did a few things with our defense on the board. But offensively, we stayed exactly with our game plan because everything we were doing is what we wanted to do. And we need not change anything. They're playing three schemes of defenses, and that's the three that they always play. And that's what we prepared for and worked on. So we needn't change.
Offensively, they had to have a lot of confidence. Even though they had scored, they knew they stopped themselves. They've
right.
got to feel like that it's just a matter of time.
And the other thing is that we knew that Nebraska had doubts now.
Mm-hmm.
They had talked, especially their quarterback, because the quarterback had said that they're going to win by 3 or 4 or 5 touchdowns. We wouldn't even be close. And he had to be totally confused now because they can't make a first down. Mm-hmm. They only had 14 yards of offense in the second quarter after they scored their touchdown drive, and I know that he's got to be concerned. And at the same time, that gives us confidence, momentum, that we know that we're in control of the football game right now.
Well, Steve Taylor, the Nebraska quarterback, gained no confidence in the third quarter, and we will have third quarter action in just a moment. Third quarter action.
They will receive, they deferred the opening half. They won the toss, we'll kick off, and no return. Kicked off with the wind. It was a pretty good wind. The wind died some late in the fourth quarter, second half. But here they come out the first series. This was an important series for them. They had to move the football. I mean, they have to come out and show some confidence and move the ball. And now they're in a 3rd and 5 situation right here. They have got to convert, and they can't do it.
Well, there was a penalty on the play before that we did not show. That was 2nd and 13 play. Now they're 3rd and 10.
3rd and 10. I'm going to throw the football. Crossing route, Ricky Dixon, great play. And I'm going to tell you why that play happened right there, because there's great coverage for number 14, Derek White. Derek White caused this. Our cornerback is playing man-to-man on the crossing route. And if we show the replay here, you'll see number 14 be following a split receiver across in front of him and tap the ball up in the air, and Ricky Dixon intercepts it. Here comes the crossing route. He throws it. See the ball tip right there by 14. Great pass coverage. Our man-to-man coverage there, Derek White and Ricky Dixon, a great runner, great free safety, punt returner, excellent athlete. Brings the ball back to 14.
gives Oklahoma great field position, first and 10 at the Nebraska 13.
Great defense. Rodney Anderson for two, second 8 from the 11. Touchdown, Oklahoma. Collins blocked, Stafford speed, hit the crack, hurdled the end zone.
You got to believe.
Believe that.
Two-play drive, 13 yards, touchdown.
Little Anthony Stafford, 5'7", 175 pounds from St. Louis, Missouri. Junior. Charles Thompson, the pitch, good block. Collins.
They had the people out there. He hit the crease and went right between them.
Split them, speed. Extra point, big play. Right down the middle. R.D. Lasher hits it. We got a tie ball game. And with the momentum our way, they can't make a first down and we move the football. Kick it deep. Start at the 20. Cross motion out, power eye, pitch sweep. Nowhere. Nowhere. Nowhere to go. Dante Jones play. Pitch sweep again. Good pursuit defense. It's going to be third and about 6. Power eye. Power play. Fourth down. Got to punt it.
It was even less, Coach. It was third down and 3 and you hold. Got to punt it. Just like you said.
Punt it away. Patrick Collins. Protect the ball. Get the ball 37-yard line. 38-yard line. Charles Thompson. Option play. Charles jumps up the field. They slammed him in the turf there, didn't they? Took the little kid. They call him the little kid. And the ball to Charles Thompson. I mean, to Rodney Anderson for a couple. Some big men there. Gets the ball to Stafford. Speed around the corner for about 7 yards.
Brings up 3rd and 4.
Pitch the ball. It'll be 4th and 1. We're going to punt the football away. Midfield. We're not going to go for it here. Let's kick them deep in the hole. Play field position for our defense. Where our defense is playing, they're having a tough time moving it. They haven't moved it, so they'll start at the 20. 7-7 ball game.
This will be Nebraska's 5th straight drive. Try 3 plays
option
and
play. Great play there, Dante Jones, All-American linebacker, coaches All-America team. Cross motion out of a power eye set. Got a scramble, people in his face. They look totally confused right now. They can't do what they want to do. They want to throw the football there. They can't. They got to scramble with it. He's got to scramble with it again. He wanted to run it. Kind of looks hully-gully, doesn't it?
Trying to find something they can hang their hat on. They're not doing it. It's 4th down and 5, and they have to punt. Boy, the defense and offense at this point are playing so confident.
Punt the ball away. Fair catch. We got confused right here. You know, we had Charles back here, but since the injury to Mayo, he had to become a quarterback. Now we had to put Collins back here, and he hadn't practiced in a while, and we had a problem communicating with Derek White. They hadn't been back here together. A couple yards to Rodney Anderson, the fullback. Gonna throw the football. Overthrows everybody here. Thank goodness. Crowd there. Charles Thompson. Right here is a pretty good lick right there. Big Washington hits our little guy, 25, and breaks up a reception. We punt the football away. And this is the best field position they've had right here. They've got 41-yard line here. They got the best field position. They need to do something. This is the big series now. Every one of them are getting big. One throw the football. They had to ad-lib that play right there. That's their first down off a busted play. Mm-hmm. They wanted to throw a pass, and he scrambled with it and finally pitched it. Counter option, pitch, ball. Good defense right there. Great pursuit. Vickers, Troy Johnson, Derek White, cross motion out of the slot, eye. Pitch sweep into the boundary. Great corner support. Good job, Troy Johnson, number 80.
Brings up 3rd and 4.
3rd and 4. Daryl Reed, in that great play, All-American defensive end, right through the fullback to the quarterback. Big play, makes him throw it in the ground. Fourth down, you got to punt it, man. A great field position, but our defense stopped them there. We start at the 20. All the way to the end zone, a touchback. 20-yard line. Jump up that field. Charlie, they pulled the ball loose right here, but Patrick Collins comes up with a big play. There was a fumble. The ball was pulled loose out of Charlie's hands after he makes about 8 yards. Cross motion, counter play, Stafford. I think we got a first down right there.
Right, first and 10 at the 30.
First and 10, moving the football. Rodney, option play. Charles Thompson, hold on that ball.
Second and 6.
Charles Thompson, pitch the ball, speed, good play. Safety there. Touchdown, Sooners. 65-yard run coming up right here. Third and 4. Great job of Damon Stell. John Green hits the ball. Great job of running. Speed. Hit the crack. And it's all over.
What do you do when you see it coming right in front of you down the sidelines? Besides get out of the way.
I get out of the way. I never get to see it. I was standing. I can't move fast enough to get to the sidelines to see if he can score. Big play. Johnny Green kicks out, enough speed to outrun Leroy, and there's a great block to Stell blocking Ken out. The motion man blocked out the corner, and you don't catch him.
Nebraska's offense in the third quarter had one first and 10. At the end of the third quarter, it's Oklahoma 14, Nebraska 7. In a moment, we'll have the fourth quarter action as Lasher adds the extra point. We'll have our sidelines feature. Don't go away. It gets better. Oklahoma leads 14-7 on the way to Miami.
In my neighborhood in Los Angeles, most of the kids either sold or used drugs. It was easy for me to see they're going nowhere. Football was my love as a youngster, and my dream was to play football for Oklahoma. I knew that if I messed up my life with drugs, I could never make those dreams come true. In order to be the best in whatever you choose to do with your life, stay away from drugs and make your dreams come true.
Fourth quarter, this has been called Oklahoma's quarter, and it doesn't change.
High formation, they're gonna throw the ball, great coverage right there, ball tipped up in the air, Ricky Dixon, another interception. Big play. Let's go score with this one now, let's get it over with. Ricky Dixon, big interception, number 2. Watch Dillon, 41. Dillon's the one that causes this, our linebacker. They're going to throw the slant pass. Dillon breaks, throws the ball. Dillon gets his hand on it, the ball up in the air. Then Derek White can tackle the receiver, pull him down, keep him from catching the football. It's legal now, and he can catch the ball right there.
That is great reaction to tackle him after he
hits the ball, option play. Got 7 yards for Collins. Ball at the 40, inside the 39, 40-yard line. Counter play, Stafford. Ball it down inside the 35 now. 5-yard gain.
First and 10 at the 34.
They'll score with it. Option play. Leroy knocks him out of bounds. Leroy's from Louisiana. Iberia. Pitch the ball. Stafford, big play to the safety. Likes the way he stuck him.
Brings up third and 10.
Catch the football here, but a call makes a great catch. Got hit pretty good, but he went out of bounds. You know, if the defensive cornerback forced him out of bounds, that's what I thought happened because he went to a 5 coverage playing a short corner. And I thought that's what happened, but on the replay it shows that he didn't push him out of bounds.
He
stepped out.
He had him crowded on the sidelines, and he took that outside release.
Right. He stepped out, and you cannot do that.
Boy,
come back in.
Heck of a catch, though.
It's a great catch. That'd been, you know, great play right there. Catch the ball at the 2-yard line. And Ben stayed in bounds all the way, and he should have. Put him in the hole. Put him at the 5-yard line. 95 yards to go.
They mark it at the 8. It'll be 1st and 10 for Nebraska.
I never thought they could score. I really never did worry about it. Unless you throw something like this and score easy. Dana Brinson, Ricky Dixon. That had a big play there, but he wouldn't have scored. He'd been tackled if he caught it. Ricky pressuring him. Run a counter play. And David Vickers, where are you, David? Oh, there you are. Big hit.
3-yard gain, 3rd and 7.
Cross motion out of fullback set. Sprint out. Throw the ball in the flat, 4th down. 6-yard pass, can't get them the first, so they're going to have to punt the football. Guy punting the ball, great. But look at the field position we'll get, because we punt them deep. We punt them to 5, don't let them make a first. We got the ball at the 50, leading 14-7. Now we have got to go score. We have got to do it this series here. Ran the fullback here for 7. Trap play, Rodney Anderson. Running, not reckless, because he's really trying to protect the ball, holding on to it with both hands. Picks up the 1st down. Unbalanced line. And the ball to fullback, big hole. Rodney wrap up the ball right here. Gets hit and knocks it loose right there. 3rd fumble by him. Little Stafford's got to go make the play and recover the ball for us. Breaking the open field. And I tell you, he's snake bit. He's really snake bit on fumbles. Collins pitches the ball. Option play. Thompson gets the ball.
Now Collins. 2nd and 6 at the 16.
Motion, counter. Stafford. Holt wraps it up. Picks up a few. Got the score here. 8:31. Trap option. Slip down right there. He was going to get the 1st down. But he slips. Oh, we're going to have a 1st and 10 going in, so we're going to kick the field goal. R.D. Lasher hits this one right through the middle. 17-7 Oklahoma.
7 minutes and 40 seconds remain in the game.
Good kickoff coverage. Kick the ball high into the wind. And we've got good coverage. Johnny Green makes a play right there, number 3. Does every time. Big play right there to Johnny. Pitch the ball. We're going to throw back to the quarterback, but we cover it. And now he's got to scramble with it, and there's Dante Jones wrapping him up, sticking him pretty good. One throw back to the quarterback. Option play, one run the option. Nowhere to go. Got to block people.
1 yard gain, 3rd and 5.
Can't block us. Can't knock us off the line of scrimmage. Get to him, Troy Johnson. Crossing route. Dante in coverage. Incomplete. Is Dana Brinson a senior?
Let's hope so.
I want him to be, because he is really a good player, a big-time player. Ricky Dixon, fair catch. Boy, this is a great drive right here. Charles Thompson, quick speed, hit the crack up the field. About a 30-yard run. Now he's got 126 yards in the game right now, I believe, at this point in time. Now we break the fullback trap the next play. Boy, you show his quickness here. Jumps inside the guy, and the fullback picks up the safety. He's just moving a little quicker than the rest of them.
30-yard gain by Charles Thompson. Makes it 1st and 10 at the 47 of Nebraska.
Fullback trap. Breaks the secondary. Hold on that ball, Rodney.
That's a 22-yard gain, so 52 yards of offense from 2 plays.
I believe they got to know right now.
They are starting to believe.
Good job of holding on the ball. I tell you what, we miss Lydell Carr. Miss all good players. Need to rest. We need to alternate people.
2nd and 7.
5-0-1. Charles Thompson, option play for about 3. Fumbled the ball right there, got it knocked loose, and I think Stafford came in there and got him another fumble recovery. He's all Big 8 fumble recoveries. Anderson, run, clock, run. Trap option, pitch the ball, 4th down, let Stafford get it. Run right over the staff. 1st down, Sooners. Making 1st downs, eat the clock up.
1st and 10, 13-yard line.
Unbalanced line, and the ball outside veer. Two tights. And the pitch ball just right here to the 5-yard line, going to go in to score. And they fumble the football. Got 2 minutes and 50 seconds left in the ball game. Collins makes a great run to get the ball to 5, and we fumble it. We'd held on the football. This might not have been close, like Steve Taylor said.
That's
great,
right.
great play, Dante Jones. Boy, we're going to miss him. He is a good football player. Great football player. I've always been a fan of his. You know, Boz always overshadowed him. I guess Boz was a great player, too. But this guy is, too. Has been through his entire career.
You saw the upsetting look on different players for Nebraska. Dante makes the interception.
4 seconds left.
Here's the last play of the game.
Last play. Vickers on a blitz. He's just going to throw it up. Keep from being sacked. And there's Finch and Ricky Dixon. The ball game is over. As soon as went, 17-7. There's my bodyguard.
Coach, congratulations. After the ball game, your feelings? What?
Well, of course, you know what the locker room's like after a win like this. You know, when you experience the championship game and the emotion that runs rampant, the pandemonium that is expressed in your locker room is, I've said many times, life holds very few moments like that, and you have to be a part of a family that enjoys or is cheered in those moments to understand really what I'm talking about, because millions of people play the game of football, and there's only very few that understand what it is to be champions and the effort and the time, all that went into it, and then be able to celebrate it when that moment does come and you enjoy it. And I tell you what, it was a great, great locker room, and I'm sure we're going to get to see quite a bit of that on our sideline feature.
That's right, Coach. It's not over till it's over. Our sideline video this week, it's very special, and it isn't over until it's over.
We can!
were many outstanding plays and outstanding players Saturday at Lincoln, Nebraska. Jerry Park introduces our players of the game.
Hello, everybody. I'm Jerry Park in the Oklahoma locker room in Lincoln, Nebraska. And at this point in time, it's the time that we normally tell you who the Oklahoma Football USA Wet Player of the Game is. But that would be kind of hard to introduce you to that person, because it's not person, it is persons. Not only did Barry Switzer give game balls to every player on the football team, but the coaching staff as well. So the entire University of Oklahoma football team is Oklahoma Football's USA Wet Player of the Game. Next stop for this football team, well, it's Miami, and they'll be the team to beat to win the national championship. Congratulations, Barry.
Well, thank you, Jerry.
Congratulations, Coach. Thank I mean, it's a great season. A lot of people felt like that as things kind of slowed down, we didn't play as well, that it may be slipping away from us, but
hey, it never did. We had a grasp on it all the way. We wanted to be 10-0 when we arrived in Lincoln, Nebraska on November the 21st. We accomplished that goal, and we knew we'd play them for the championship, and we had confidence that we would win the football game because we thought we were the better team.
And now you go to almost becoming what's your second home, Miami, Florida.
Well, this will be four consecutive years we've gone to Miami, and of course our senior class has won four games over Texas and four over Nebraska. That was something that was a goal that they wanted to accomplish, and with that, we'd obviously go for Orange Bowls. And I don't know how the Orange Bowl people feel about it. I'm sure that they would like for someone else to be there because of fan support. But I think that we'll probably take more support this year than we have in years past, because this game, other than Penn State year, will be for the national championship. And the others weren't necessarily, but this one will, with no doubt.
Coach, it's been Miami that's been kind of the downfall for Oklahoma in the last
few times. We've won 33 out of 35 of the last games played since we lost to Washington in the Orange Bowl. We've won 33 and lost two, and that's to Miami, to Vinny Testaverde. But he's in professional football now. Maybe they're not as good, and hopefully we can handle them third time.
What kind of game do you expect?
Well, I don't know anything about Miami. I haven't looked at the film. I've read a lot about them during the year. I read their game results, their rushing game. I'm sure they got talented people, but they don't rush the football like Nebraska does. But they throw the football, obviously, a little better than Nebraska or better than Nebraska. They haven't been inspired. I mean, you look at us against some of the people we played, we weren't playing inspirational football. We did yesterday. Miami will rise to the occasion when they have to. I expect it from them, the type of athletes they have. They've been kind of playing nobodies, and Toledo yesterday was a nobody to them, and the week before that, VPI, and they played them close.
Coach, the seniors, they came when things were not so good here at Oklahoma, and they have to be very special in your mind.
They are. I talked about that this week to them and thanked them for what they did in bringing Oklahoma back to the pinnacle. They were recruited in 83 on a kind of a down cycle, and this group here has brought us back to the top again, and they've done it by producing the best fit teams in college football the past 4 years. Their record is better than anyone.
Okay, Coach, it's been a lot of fun being with you this year.
Thank you, Steve. Always enjoy it.
Well, thank you very much. We've had a lot of fun on Oklahoma football. We want to say thank you to all of you along the cable systems and television stations all across the country that have carried Oklahoma football through 11-0 and the number one ranking now as we finish the season. We thank all of you that have helped us here at the home station KOCO and TV in Oklahoma City. For all of us of Oklahoma football, we'll see you next year, and hopefully we'll be able to talk about Oklahoma's seventh national championship team. Thank you.
Oklahoma football has been brought to you by Budweiser, Beechwood Aged for that clean, crisp taste. This Bud's for you. And by USA Wet, America's best-tasting sports drink. Clothing for Barry Switzer and Steve Davis is provided by Harold's, Oklahoma City, Norman, and Tulsa.